Good morning, I'm Dan Ford. I'm with Ophir Spyricon and cover the southwestern United States. I demonstrate the beam profiling equipment as well as the photon scanning slit equipment and our power and energy meters. What we're going to be talking about today is beam profiling. And we have a number of different tools for that, one of which is a nanoscan. This uses a slit technology, and we are able to cover ranges from the 190s clear out into the micron range. We have three different models. Then we also have CCD technology for profiling. And this is what we're primarily going to use today. This is from 190 out to 1300 nanometer applications. We also have cameras that can work with pyroelectrics, and that will cover you right on through to the 3000 micron range. All this equipment interfaces through beam gauge software. The beam gauge software is sort of the heart and soul of it all. With the use of our profiling equipment, the cameras, scanning slits, etc., we're able to tie that into the beam gauge. Beam gauge is where we're going to do all of our work. So here you can see I'm looking at a Heaney laser with a CCD camera, and we're able to see the characteristics in it. Every laser, whether it's a Heaney or a YAG laser or CO2, there's all kinds of lasers. They all have beam issues until they're fixed. But you've got to know when they need fixed, and that's where we come in. So the beam can change over time. Just the everyday use will change that beam shape over time and the characteristics. So it's kind of like a pencil. You've got a pencil, it's unsharpened, you can jab things with it, doesn't do much work for you. You sharpen it up, now you got a nice fine point, you start writing with it, looks real good. But over time, that shape changes that lead, and that changes what your mark looks like. So whether you're welding, drilling, cutting, whatever it is, ablating, that shape is critical to what you're going to get for a result. So that's where the tools to find out when the time comes that you need to work on that laser comes in. And in here we've got beam gauge. So now we're able to look at the beam and see just how that power or energy, if you're working pulsed, is distributed throughout the beam and how it's shaped. This is going to determine what kind of work it's going to do for you. Now, this here is a fairly weak source. We're looking at it through a CCD camera using an LBS 300 attenuation package to get the power down to a safe level, not to destroy your testing equipment. And to enhance that, we can go into the beam gauge and just move the Z scale up to give us a little more representation of what we're going to look at in that beam. So we're just enhancing it with the software. We're not going to damage the equipment because we aren't adding power from the laser. So we can see a little more detail in the beam here. And this is a 2D image. Some people, they like to look at it in a 3D image. So when this software was developed, it was developed with the customer in mind and their ability to personalize it, to set it up the way they want to see representations on the screen. So now we're looking at it in 3D, and just looking at a straight on view sometimes isn't the best. We're able to rotate that around. We're able to zoom in on it, look at particular parts of the beam as we're going down the sides of it, look down here in the fringe of the beam to see if there's anything down there that would be causing a problem. And it just makes it easy. Now, if you want to look at that in both 2D and 3D, we can just undock this. And move it. Put it over here on the side. In conclusion, all lasers have problems. And without the proper diagnostics tools, you don't know when that problem is in the early stages or the advanced stages and costing you money. So with the proper profiling equipment, we're able to solve those. You're able to check your equipment on a regular basis. So for more information, please feel free to visit our website. It's www.ophir.com. www.ophiropt.com/photonics. Thank you.